He liked his life, and he saw a lot of fun ahead, that I do know. And I never saw a man so difficult to wear down. What they call whipcord and india rubber. Nothing tired him or got him finished. Not scenes, nor threats, nor being short of money, nor being in danger. And when I say I didn't think anything really bad was going to happen, I mean to say I didn't think it was going to happen to him. The court was tense enough now. You could hear the soft sound of breath that has been held, because none of us dared make so much noise as a gasp, whistling suddenly through dry lips. Here was drama, and the least significant of us was moved and involved. Baines could offer us nothing further, and the evidence for the day closed there. The position was highly unsatisfactory, and everyone knew it. The coroner rose and weightily explained their duties to the jury. If, he told them, in the face of everything they'd heard, they could conscientiously say that Rafe met his death by accidental means, then they must do that. If they weren't satisfied, they must say so. The jury seemed to have a good deal to talk about, and were away a long time. When they returned, the foreman said they weren't satisfied as to the actual cause of death. Medical evidence had conflicted, and in their view there were too many additional factors in the case for them to come to any conclusion with an easy mind. They didn't think it possible, even if accidental death were ruled out, to bring in a verdict against any particular person, since, although they had good reason to believe that several people wished the deceased out of the way, no evidence had been offered to show the movements of any of these people during the important hours. They considered that the case warranted a great deal more inquiry, and regretted their inability to bring in a definite verdict. And there, for the day, the matter had to stand. The funeral was fixed for 4 days ahead.